morning. So last class we just discussed about the little boy who is going to find a strange house. Okay, I think you got an idea of actually what the story tell us. Okay, so here we are going to start the remaining part. Look at the page number 76. The little boy turned around the next corner and down the block. Every house had windows and doors. Some were red and some had chimneys, but not one of them was a little round red house with no windows and no doors, a chimney on top and the star in the middle. The little boy turned. Turned means march or moved. Moved around the next corner and the down the block. Then he again, the little boy just began to walk to find out the strangest house. Then it said every house had windows and doors and some were red, but had a chimney also, but none of them is a little round red one. It means the little boy could not see the strangest house among the house that he saw just before. Then he stopped again to think and looked up to see a police car cruising down the street. It pulled up alongside him and a police officer poked her head out of the window. A little boy, are you lost? Then the boy just stopped there and he began to think, where is it? That time, a police vehicle just stopped, pulled near him, and the police officer just poked his her head out and asked, hey, why are you standing here? Are you lost the way to your home? Oh no, the little boy replied, I live at Ivy Rock Lane, Bridgewater, New Jersey. Oh no, ma'am. Then I am here. This is my address. I live in the Ivy Rock Lane, Bridgewater, New Jersey. He just said the correct address. Oh, that's right around the block. The police officer said, no, you are not lost. Oh, that's very near. You are not lost. Are you? Are you don't lost your way to your home? The little boy asked, do you know where everyone was? Everyone lives around here. I am looking for a special house. I asked the mail carrier and he did not know where is it. Ma'am, do you know where all the people live here? Then I am searching a special kind of house. I just asked about the mail carrier, but he said that he don't know where it was. The police officer said, little boy, I know this neighborhood like the back of my hand. Oh no, yes, very well. Then I am here to help you. Then tell me, I know each and everyone. Then I am here as the back of my hand means very well. I know very well every people in the street. I drive up this street and down this street every day. I just make a patrolling through the street each and every day. So because of that, I know it's an every people in the street. Then making sure things are safe around here. What house do you want to find? The police officer said that I just make a patrolling here to the protect of the people. I am the responsible person to protect all the villages here. So tell me, I know everyone. So what kind of house do you want to find out? The little boy said, my mother sent me to find a little round red house with no windows and no doors, a chimney on top and the star in the middle. A police officer, madam, then my mom just sent me here to find out a special kind of house. It has no doors and windows, but a chimney and a star also inside him. It's a house that I want to find out. Then to find out that strange house, my mom just sent me out. Then can you help me? The little boy, the officer said, I have been past every house in the town, but I have never seen a house like that before. Oh, my little boy, I know each and every house in the street, but I never ever saw such a house before in the street. What is it? What kind of house is it? You are sure that's what your mother said? Are you sure? Are you sure that your mother is correct or not? Oh yes, the little boy answered. She said she found the same house when she was just my age, so I know it's real. Yes, my mother is correct. Because my mother said me that when she was a child, she also found out the same one. So I know it's very real. My mom does not cheat me, does not make me fool. Then the police officer said, sorry, I can't help you, buddy. I have got to be getting back to my street patrol. Sorry, I can't help you. So it's time to make a patrolling here. So I am going. Waving goodbye, she drove out down the road. Then the police officer also just say goodbye, and he just drove off the vehicle through the street. The little boy was getting discouraged. Then finally, the little boy was disappointed. Then he became disappointed. Then he searched everywhere, but he could not find out the house. Then his mother said he would not even need to cross the street. But no matter how hard he looked, he could not find the house he was looking for. His mother remembered him that at first his mother told him that he don't want to cross the street. But the little boy searched everywhere in the street, but he could not find the house, the strangest house. Then, there was just one more house to check, and that was Mr. Fetzer's house at the end of the block. Then there was only one house remaining to check. The final, it was the Fetzer house. Mr. Fetzer had lived in the neighborhood longer than anyone. Then Mr. Fetzer then has been living there since years ago. So years and years ago, there were many farms in the Bridgewater. years ago. In the Bridgewater means a place. Then there were many farm cultivating potter, and but one by one the land had been sold and house were built where there had once been field of jessery, tomato and white corn. Years ago, all the farm were cultivated by tomato and corns, jessery tomato and corns. But one by one had been sold, and the people just built the house in that farm place. So there is no much farms there right now. Then he ran a small farm stand and sold the fresh fruit and vegetable he grew in his garden and orchard. The Mr. Fetzer, he just ran a shop, and he sells a fresh vegetable and fruits that he cultivated from his garden. It's a very nice one. It's a nice good job. If anyone knows what that house is, he should. Then the little boy reasoned. Then the little boy began to guess that if anyone know the strangest house in the street, it only should be in the Mr. Fetzer, because Mr. Fetzer know very well each and every word in that street. So up he trudged to Mr. Fetzer van and peered inside. The little boy walked with the tired to the Mr. Fetzer shop and peered inside. Peered means looked inside. There was a farmer packing apple into the boxes. There he saw a man who just packing the apple into the boxes. He looked up. "Why, hello there, young fellow. What can I do for you? Come for a taste of my apple cider." Then then he looked up. The man just looked up and said that, "Oh, what is that? Then what do you want? What help I want to do for you? Then come on, tell me. Then come and taste the apple cider." What do you mean the apple cider? The apple wine. It is used in the European countries, then Indian also. So let's wind up the class here. Then I think you can understand the second part also. It's a very nice and very easy story. So you have to read one or more time. One or more time to read the story. You don't want to read thousand and thousand and hundred times like the little boy. You have to read only one or two times, then you can understand, because the story is very simple. So anyway, thank you for hearing me. Let's meet another episode.